Gentlemen's time has expired. I yield myself 5 minutes for questions. Ms. Spector, the Department of Interior proposed a rule in December, I believe, that would restrict public access to its records. Under the rule, Interior could, quote, impose a monthly limit for processing records, end quote, for an individual requester. I'm curious, what's the monthly limit that Interior is proposing?
Well, Congressman, this is a work in progress, and I'd like to explain that. During the past 2 years, the department has seen a significant increase in complex requests that are seeking any and all records that result in the collection of a large volume of material, and this creates the monthly processing limit proposal is an effort to equalize the provision of records to all FOIA requesters, and so that if you have a small group of requesters whose requests consist of hundreds of thousands of pages of documents, that if we produce only a portion to them in a monthly period, that we can then provide more responses to more requesters.
Right. So I get that. I understand that. What's the number?
There actually isn't a set number, and as I was describing a little bit earlier, in the context of FOIA non-response litigation, we have a separate track of processors who work only on those matters. And we calculate a monthly processing capability based on the number of litigated matters, the number of processors, and the estimated page number that each processor can complete in a month.
The reason that concerns me is, first of all, I'm not sure a monthly limit really comports with the spirit of FOIA. I mean, the agencies to which these inquiries are directed are under an obligation to respond, and a monthly limit would appear to cut against that obligation. But also, I'm particularly troubled at this notion that the monthly limit could just change based on I mean, I understand from your point maybe why that could make some sense, but the potential to, in a sense, manipulate the monthly limit from month to month, either based on the kinds of requests that had come in previously or in anticipation of requests that may be coming, could allow for a lot of mischief. And you understand what I'm saying? You could anticipate, oh, this group is going to be making these numbers of requests, so let's set the monthly limit here for the next month, and that'll knock them down. And then another month comes along, and you change it again, potentially to respond to another group. And the reason that concerns me is there's potential for politics to get in the mix. I understand that Western Values Project, which is a nonprofit based in Montana, was one of the organizations that had frequently requested records from the Interior over the past 2 years. And the former Secretary of the Interior, Ryan Zinke, went on television and was disparaging the group. They're operatives of the Democratic Party, they're hacks, they've always been, they need to be investigated, et cetera. I'm concerned that these monthly limits may be, are being instituted potentially as a way of limiting the inquiries coming from certain groups based on their politics. Was this rule drafted in any way in response to that particular group that you're aware of?
Absolutely not.
Do you understand my concern about how monthly limits could be manipulated based on experience or anticipation of what be coming in? Do you see that as an issue?
I would agree that a monthly limit scenario that was applied arbitrary and capriciously could result in that outcome. But I would also say that the process that we anticipate is a process by which we assess our capacity and provide the greatest number of FOIA responses to the greatest number of requesters each month. And that at the end of the day, that promotes the spirit of the FOIA to a greater extent than focusing on a small subset of requesters who eat up all the time of the FOIA processors with these large requests that involve thousands of pages of documents.
Well, you haven't completely assuaged my anxiety on this point, so I'd ask the department to go back and take a closer look at this rule, because I think there's the potential for it to be used in a way that cuts against the obligations under FOIA. With that, I'll yield back my time.